not your playground. Many of us have heard this line numerous times till it became a cliche. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Ishpreet Kaur, an academic consultant and a trainer serving the education industry since past 7 years. Precisely 3 decades ago, it was discovered that there are several neurons present in our brain which are responsible for the learning that happens. Now the question arises, if there are neurons in our brain, how does it aid to the learning? Well, when these neurons make neural connections, learning happens. It is more like the landline phones that we have precisely, say, 2 decades back when we were younger. So for making a call successful, we had those network, the cords which were connected to the landline system. So that's how the neural connections build. And when the neural connections build, that process is known as synapses. I think all of us would agree that this 3-pound mass resting between our shoulders is responsible for most of our learning. But for me, learning does not happen neck up. It happens feet up. Yes? So it is said that learning and physical activity is interrelated and intertwined. So for this, I would narrate a short story to you all. So this story is about a fry who's a young one of a fish and a tadpole who's young one of a frog. Thank you so much. So this fish, this fry and tadpole, they are best of their friends and play in a small pond all together. So they share their happiness, they share their sorrows together, and they play together. One fine day, the tadpole realized that it has started, something strange has started happening to its body. It had started growing limbs. So, astonished by this process, the tadpole went to the fry and explained the entire thing, how last night it slept and jab wo subah utha, to something strange happened to its body aur uske limbs grow hone lag gaye the. So, days passed by, the tadpole realized that yes, it has the tendency to live in water and outside water as well. So, the tadpole realized that since it had the tendency to survive outside the water, why not to explore the environment outside? So, jab wo pond ke bahar gaya, it realized that there is something strange moving around in the sky. A strange creature is flying up in the sky, having 2 wings and a long beak. The tadpole had never seen that kind of creature in the pond. Now, once the tadpole had seen that, it tried to move further. So, when it went a little further, it saw there was even a stranger animal. An animal, a creature, who is a bulky animal who's grazing on grass and is white in color. Astonished by this, it went further ahead aur jab wo aur aage gaya, usko aur bhi 2 zyada ajeeb animals dikhe. He saw that there were 2 creatures, one was this much and the other one was this tall. Both were holding hands together. The shorter one had something on its back and they were facing towards each other, moving their lips like this. So the tadpole went back into the water and narrated the entire incident to the fry. Now probably they have grown into a frog and a fish. So when he narrated the entire incident to the fry, the fish had imagined in her own mind how the first creature would look like, जो ऊपर उड़ रहा था, it had a long beak and it had wings. So what according to you that creature would have been? A bird? Okay. So let's see how the what the fish thought that animal would have been. So the fish thought that जो उसको description मिली उस animal की वो ये थी. The one over there at the top. The second creature which the frog saw, what would it have been according to you? Was grazing on grass, was a bulky one, a cow? Okay. So this is how the fish imagined the cow to be. Does a cow really look like this? No. Now when the frog went further, उसने जो और दो स्ट्रेंज एनिमल्स देखे, एक के पीछे कुछ लटका हुआ था, एंड बोथ वर होल्डिंग हैंड्स टुगेदर, दे वर फेसिंग टुवर्ड्स ईच अदर, एंड द फिश इमेजिन दैट दोज टू क्रीचर्स टू बी लाइक दिस. वी नो इट वुड हैव बीन ह्यूमंस, इट वुड हैव बीन ह्यूमंस, बट ह्यूमंस डोंट लुक लाइक दिस. The what do you think, what was the probable reason why the fish had imagined the three creatures to look like this? Absolutely, that's what they have seen, that's what they were raised, that's what they were raised around. So the point here is, though I do not mean to say that a fish thinks alike the way humans think, but the idea behind sharing this story was that the amount of exposure we give to our children results in the learning. So if we talk about learning, it has to have some movement in it. According to a study, I'll just show you a graph which states the relationship between learning, academic performance and movement. And it has come into the scenario that move your body to grow your brain. So the more we move our body, the better will be our brain functionality. Now how does this happen? When we move our body, more oxygen flows to the brain and thus resulting in better concentration, better memory, and of course the physical activeness is there. According to the Center of Disease Control and Prevention, US, physical activity has an impact on the cognitive skills such as concentration and attention, memory, and thus linking it with memory. So now I would request you all, since we are talking about how memory is linked with movement, I would request you all to please stand up and perform one short activity. Please. वैसे ही थकी हुई हो? अच्छा, ओके. सो व्हाट वी हैव टू डू विद योर एल्बो, यू हैव टू राइट योर नेम विद योर राइट एल्बो, यू हैव टू राइट योर नेम. सो इफ इट्स Ishtpreet, I'm going to write my name like this. Now with your left elbow, are we done? Okay, perfect. Koi aise bhi karega tab bhi kuch nahi pata chalega kiska naam kya hai. Okay, so with your left elbow, now we got to write our you got to write your mother's name. Wow. And now with your body, you've got to write your father's name. Twist your body the way you can. I could make out what your father's name is. Just joking. Yes, absolutely. Can we have a big round of applause for her? So did you notice the difference, the magic that movement has in our lives? So let's inculcate movement in our classrooms and make it an interactive learning environment, And thereby, I conclude by saying that movement breaks should be given to the students maybe after 20 to 30 minutes of their learning. That's it. Thank you so much. Thank you for being good listeners. Thank you.